The Waves Factory Echo Cat is an emulation of the famous Watkins Copycat tape delay. Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. The Copycat is different from, let's say, a Roland Space Echo in that it doesn't add a reverb tank to the sound. It's purely a tape delay. The Waves Factory Echo Cat is a plugin which is really simple to use. I will show you on this dub type loop on this Skank guitar part. Let's go over the controls. The default shows without any shame that it is a tape echo emulation. There's a bypass knob, input volume and output volume. The input gain lets you drive the plugin. With this guitar, it adds a bit of high frequency saturation. You compensate the extra gain with the output volume. Here's the sustain knob, also known for delay plugins as the feedback dial. For tape delay emulation plugins, this must drive into self-oscillation, which this plugin does. A dry wet mix control is added so this plugin can be used as an insert like I do on this guitar. And what is a delay plugin without the ability to set the delay times? By pressing heads, you go to the delay settings. There are three heads, which are three separate delay times. They all cover the same delay times from 25 milliseconds to 1200 milliseconds. And you can sync them individually with the sync knob. The delay times will go from 1/32nd of a note to 1 bar. The original Copycat had fixed ratios for the delay, but the plugin doesn't. I think this is a sensible change. The plugin has to fit in a digital environment. It does not need to be a one-on-one copy of the original unit. Each delay has the same controls like volume, stereo panning to create a stereo delay, and a high and a low pass filter. The three delays can be turned on and off with this switch down here. So if you only need one or two delays, that can be done. The tape section lets you change the sound of the tape delay from, let's say, clean to dirty. You can change the tape like artifacts like wow, flutter, age and signal. And there's a tape loop gap dial to add even more authenticity to the delay, if you fancy that. It even includes a tape hiss noise generator, which does hiss in mono or stereo and can be muted while there is a signal. The motor dial adds more variation and movement. You can add hum on 50 or 60 Hz if you feel that adds something to the delay. And the auto mute doesn't seem to do anything on this guitar. For me, the hum and mute could have been removed from the plugin. Maybe you have a use for it. The vary speed controls also feed into the modulation feed. No syncing here, you have to set these by ear. The master section has a very interesting ducking feature with amount and speed controls and can be set to stereo or mid of a mid-side signal. Speaking of mid-side, the plugin can do mid-side balancing with these dials. A fake stereo effect and true stereo. Handy extra features. The global tone can be adjusted with bass, treble and a high and low pass. Let's tweak around with the plugin on the guitar, but first listen through the plugin with the preset Apply to Hits on the last snare. Nice for dub. Now let's play around with the plugin on guitar. The EchoCat is a nice, good-sounding tape emulation. You can get tape-style effects with a very easy-to-use interface. Waves Factory fortunately did add features to not only have an emulation of a Watkins copycat, but also to have a tape delay fitting for the modern-day workflow. It has a different vibe and sound than, for instance, the T-Rex Space Delay, which emulates a Roland Space Echo. You must see the review of that plugin. It's displayed on screen right now. Please remember to subscribe and like this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!